Good morning. Well, did the earth move for you last night? Many householders in the north of England certainly were moved when they were woken at 1 a.m. by a violent earthquake measuring 5.6 on the Richter scale. Houses were damaged, chimneys fell through the roof, and people were injured as the earth shook violently for 10 seconds. It is believed to be the largest earthquake to hit the UK in 25 years. To find out more, we asked an expert for his views.
Hello! I'm an expert from the Royal Geographical Society in Edinburgh. And as you can see from my map, the epicentre of this earthquake was in Market Raisin. Market Raisin here to the south of Pocklington. What was awful and surprising was that these tremors extended all the way to Pocklington, which is here. The reason for this tectonic activity is because there is a fault between two tectonic plates. These tectonic plates are found all over the world. However, this tectonic plate runs from Russia here all the way through Europe, through Pocklington, and all the way to Iceland. And this is the not my fault. Spooky. Back to the studio.
Well, it appears the not my fault was responsible for considerable damage to Pocklington Grammar School early this morning. We can now go over live to our reporter Phil Donaldson at the scene.
Good morning. Here I am today, standing in the remains of what was once Pocklington School's boys' changing rooms. The earthquake, which struck at 1 o'clock last night, destroyed a part of this school's unique heritage. Here to talk about last night's earth-shattering events is the new headmaster, Mr. Ronan.
Good morning.
Mr. Ronan, you've lost a very architecturally significant part of the school. How will the school react?
We will take stock of the situation and be thankful that nobody was killed. After all, it was only bricks and mortar.
But surely, Mr. Ronan, it's more than that. This was the place where William Wilberforce, Tom Stoppard, even Adrian Edmondson sat on the toilet.
I understand your concerns, and I am sure we will rebuild this fine building in their honour in the near future.
How have the pupils been reacting?
The few I have seen do appear concerned, but the matter of a small earthquake won't alter their daily routine.
There's a very strange smell around here. Are you not concerned about that?
That rotten smell is a broken sewer, but we will soon have it fixed.
Will you have to close the school?
No. Pocklington School is open for business as usual. I'm off now to arrange a new assembly. Thank you.
So, despite this disaster, Pocklington School is still open for business. Shirts are tucked in, top buttons are done up, and there's a 360-degree commitment to success. And myself, I've got a souvenir. A toilet seat, perhaps the very toilet seat that William Wilberforce, Adrian Edmondson, or Tom Stoppard sat upon. I'm off for eBay. This is Phil Donaldson for the Morning News in Pocklington.
Thank you, Phil. I'll also be putting my bid for the toilet seat on eBay. To answer the question of why this is happening, we have a local historian in our lead studio who claims the quake was predicted many years ago. Professor Strangeways, could you explain your findings?
Yes, I must refer you to an ancient manuscript, which I found in a second-hand car boot sale in York.
It appears to be written in a strange, weird writing style.
That's correct. After months of ceaseless searching, I came across a professor of Oxford University, an expert in weird calligraphy. And he deciphered the text and came up with this translation.
So what did it say?
Well, I'll refer you to the translation of this page. After the second rising of the third waning moon, at the start of the year of Thale, there will be a great catastrophic upheaval. The earth will crack and split, releasing all the evil spirits of the underworld.
You mean the earthquake could have released evil spirits from the bowels of the earth?
Yes, it could be that way. If we believe the translation, we could all be doomed.
Well, thank you very much for such a happy outlook. So there we are. Devastating earthquake damage to property, spirits rolling the environment, and a prophecy of doom. On that happy note, we'll go over to the weatherman for today's forecast.
Good morning. I know many of you were affected by this morning's earthquake. I can reassure you these are freak events, and thankfully, no one has been hurt. Because of the damage to the school, we have cordoned off the area, so please keep well away. Now, are there any questions?
Sir, will the school be closed?
As I said on the news this morning, the school will not close and we will carry on as normal.
But sir, what about these dreadful smells?
I understand your concerns, but we believe it is harmless and just a smell relating it to an old changing room.
Changing rooms are not, surely there's a health risk.
To reassure you all, I will be asking a team from the health department to investigate the smell.
What about the old historian who claims the earthquake has released the powers of evil from the bowels of the earth?
I wouldn't bother yourself with such bunkum. You've more important things to worry about, like exams. Now, if there are no more questions, let us fill our lungs with fresh air and sing All Things Bright and Beautiful.
Steve, can I come in?
Sorry, top security. Do you know the password?
Password? Are you mad?
Yes, password. We're on red alert.
Red alert? What are you talking about?
Data protection and all that. Say the password and you can come in.
The password. Let me think. I bet it's two coffees.
Two coffees. How did you guess? Correct. I suppose I'll have to let you in. What do you want?
I want to look at last night's CCTV pictures of when the earthquake struck.
Well, I've better things to do, more important things to do than that. I've got to go and get two coffees. Have a look if you want.
What do I do here?
Are you alright? Can you manage?
Don't know what I'm looking at.
Well, go back 6 hours. It occurred at 1:30 this morning.
All right. My God! Look! Look at that! It's true! The earth has cracked and all the weird evil spirits have escaped! I must tell somebody! David, quick! I've got something to show you. Get over to the IT lab, pronto!
Okay, I'm coming over now. What have you got to show me, Jonathan?
I've been checking the CCTV footage from last night's earthquake. Have you followed?
I don't think so, but why all the secrecy?
What I'm going to show you is going to shock you.
It's not another body piercing, is it, Jonathan?
No, something more shocking. Look at the CCTV footage from last night.
What the heck is that?
You are looking at ectoplasmic spectrals.
Elastoplastic spectrals? What are they?
Electroplasmic spectrals. They're also called ghosts.
Ghosts? Where have they come from?
It appears the earthquake has released them from the Earth.
You mean the weird historian on the news this morning was correct?
Yes, after the second rising of the third waning moon at the start of the year of Thale, there will be a great catastrophic upheaval. The Earth will crack and split, releasing all the evil spirits of the underworld.
What, you mean we're all doomed? But I've only just started teaching, it's not fair!
Listen, calm down. We must find a solution to this problem. The school and the world's survival depends on us.
The world's survival depends on us?
Yes, and you must not say a word to anybody about what you've just seen.
All right, okay, my lips are sealed.
You two, what are you doing in here?
Nothing, just looking at ghosts! nothing to do with you.
Listen, you two. I know you're hiding something, and if you don't tell me, I'll pull out all these wires and you'll both get the sack.
Well, should I tell her?
Tell her! I don't want to get the sack!
Okay, but for David's sake, you are sworn to secrecy.
Girl Guide's honour. I like secrets.
Look at these images of last night's earthquake.
What are we going to do?
Run!
Stop! We can beat these things. We'll find a solution on the internet.
You mean the future of the school depends on us? How exciting!
No pressure then.
Right, you two, do some research in the library.
What about the CCTV footage?
I'll deal with that. Right, now to delete the footage. Change the password on the door. Done.
Did you find what you wanted?
No, the computer must have crashed or something, but cheers anyway, thank you.
Surprised. What a surprise. Two coffees! Two coffees! What's happened to the password?
Hey, we changed it to red alert. Well, can't be too careful. Steady, that coffee!
Oh, for goodness sake, this is going to take forever to clear up.
I'll give you a hand.
Oh, thanks, Nathan.
Oh, my. The books. Mrs. E.
They've just been aftershocks. Come on.
They're floating.
No, come on.
Mrs. E, there's one going to us. Ah!
Stop screaming. We're here. We understand.
You do? You understand?
Just keep calm. Just remember, it's a library.
What's up with him?
Delayed reaction due to aftershocks.
But I saw her.
A few books flying around, that's all. Go on, keep calm. Off you go now. Off you go.
Oh, look at this mess. It's worse than when the sixth formers come in here.
Don't you think we'd better sit down?
Oh,
Angie?
I'm all right.
Angie, look out! It's gonna... Just
come to return this book.
Oh, I wonder where that's gone. Thank you.
We've just got a bit of lesson preparation to do. Can we pop upstairs? Oh, you
use the computers up there. I'll carry on cleaning up down here.
Thank you.
I'll Google ghosts.
And I'll Google designer outfits.
Nikki, this is serious. We've got to solve this problem or you'll never be able to go shopping again.
I'll take it seriously. Okay.
Right, from now on it's serious. I think we all know what to do.
I've Googled a list of all the equipment that we need.
And I think I can make a sonic plasma gun.
A sonic plasma gun? Wow.
Really? Hey, David, you really know how to impress the ladies with that sonic plasma gun.
Some of us have got it, Jonathan. Some of us haven't.
Okay, do you think we've got everything?
Yeah.
Excellent. Let's go to the art department.
Did you find what you were looking for?
You know what it's like, Angie. You have to stay ahead of the game.
Just remember, Angie, there could be aftershocks.
Aftershocks?
Yes, and they can do very strange things to a baby your age.
What? Sheep!
Ghost, you stupid...
Yes?
No. Good shot.
It won't kill ghosts, it just stuns them.
Pity.
Just save all the anger for the ghosts. Shh.
But if we can't kill them, how do we get rid of them?
That's where the trap comes in. The ghost trap emits a sonic signal which is irresistible to ectoplasm.
Ectoplasm?
When we see a ghost, we stun it.
We set the trap.
Ghost goes in.
We shut the lid. And we got it!
Yes!
Then what do we do with the ghosts?
We transfer all the ghosts to the plasmatron.
They'll be safe in there until we decide what to do with them.
Why don't we just destroy them?
Don't you remember your physics? Antimatter can't be destroyed. It's got to be put back where it came from.
You mean the bowels of the Earth?
Yes, we need to find the portal that they came from so that they can be returned to the Earth.
But how can we move around the school without causing a panic?
I'm going to write an email to the headmaster's secretary posing as Pockbusters health consultants. Come on, let's go! Dear Jan, we are Pockbusters health consultants and we hear you have a problem.
Andrew, I'm a little concerned about the pupils.
Hey, what's up, Doc?
They're complaining about the spell. Some of them are seeing apparitions.
Apparitions?
Yes, weird creatures roaming the corridors.
You must reassure them it's caused by aftershocks. It's a form of mass hysteria.
You're right, Andrew. Yes, it's just the aftershocks. You're right, I didn't think of that.
Listen, Doc, this mustn't get out to the press. Do you understand?
Yes, no, I understand, Andrew.
Job's on the line, Doc. Comprende?
Oui. Tets could roll, Andrew.
Actum, Doc. If this gets out to the parents, they'll start withdrawing pupils. And
finite, Pocklington. Comprende?
Si, dottore. But what are you going to do about it?
Oh, wecky thump. Right, I'll reassure everybody that they're suffering from aftershocks.
Remember, Doc, the future of this great and historic school is in your hands!
Oh, merci. Virtute veritate. You can rely on me.
Auf Wiedersehen, Doc.
Janice, did you get anywhere with the health?
Yes, Andrew. Contacted a local firm by email. And strangely enough, they're coming down the drive at the moment.
Them a tour of the school. Pronto. Who you gonna
call? Yes, Lorna still is here and she'll take them on a tour of the school.
I ain't afraid of no ghosts.
Is there anything in particular that you'd like to see?
Yes, we'd like to see everything. It's time to take our goggles off.
Why, do you know how many germs there are on a pinhead?
No, I don't!
Well, neither do I. That's how big this problem is. So less of the questions. Let's get down to some germ busting.
Wait, I've got a reading on a plasma spectrometer. There's one coming.
There's one at four?
Let's see how many ghosts there are in this school. Let's go.
What is that?
It's one of them!
Bothered. He'll be all right in half an hour.
We're going to have to do better than this, otherwise we're not going to get any school left to save.
It's not my fault.
It's not my fault!
Let's go.
Inspectors.
Well, the management thinks we are health inspectors.
What the blazes is going on?
The school's in the grip of bubonic plague, and you lot want to dress up like health inspectors?
One more wisecrack out of you, and I'll blast you with my plasma gun.
Steady on, Dave. I think we'd better tell them the truth.
Yes, come on, tell us the truth.
This mustn't go beyond these four walls. When the earthquake struck, it released ghosts.
Ghosts? Are you mad?
Yes, if you saw that loony historian on the TV this morning, his story was right.
You mean all the evils of the earth are in this school?
Unfortunately, yes.
Well, I think someone should go and tell the police.
Stop! So what are you going to do then?
You tell the police, and the parents will find out. They'll start withdrawing the kids from the school, which means end of Pocklington School and the end of your job.
We've surveyed the school, and there are several ghosts in most of the departments.
We suggest that you get yourselves into teams and go on a ghost hunt this weekend.
But what about the necessary equipment?
We'll supply you with that.
But how do we catch them?
Stun them with the gun, then set the trap.
Then what?
We take the traps back to the DC, where we store the ghosts in the plasmatron, and then return them to the underworld.
That sounds a good idea. I'll organise some teams.
Remember, not a word to the management. Jobs are on the line.
Okay, everyone. Who's going to be in the teams? Right, volunteers? Yeah?
It looks like we're going to have to clear the top corridor.
I still can't believe this is happening. This could be the end of Pocklington.
Look, Steve, this is all nonsense. There is no such thing as ghosts.
I'm not taking any chances. If I have to use this thing, I will.
No harm in being prepared for the worst.
I'm with you on this. If I have to use this thing, I will. It's them or us.
It's all rubbish, girls, and you know it. Anyone from the official school?
Oh, come on, girls. We haven't time to be messing about with sweets. It's time I went to do the modern languages corridor. Come on.
OK, guys, I'll just check out the maths department, OK? Oh.
Something's stolen my...
sweets.
I'm getting a reading on the plasma thermogenic.
Well, it could be the thief that took my licorice all sorts.
Or it could be the thing that's going to wipe us all out.
Come on, we've got another job to do. Come on.
Do you think I should wear? I really can't decide. Blue ones or red ones?
I don't know. Does it make any difference?
Well, a girl's got to look her best, you know, and this gear really isn't suitable. It needs some definite alterations. Hostie, will you help me?
I'm not going to help you.
Fine, be like that then. You know, I really can't decide. What do you think?
I'm sure you'll attract the ghosts if they're around.
And anyone else who's looking.
You know, I really still can't decide. The red would go better with my belt. I really don't know.
What's happening to my shoes? My most expensive shoes! Where are they going?
Get your kit off, or on. We're going on a ghost hunt. Guns away, let's get in.
Come on, guys, I really need those shoes for tonight.
Look, they're going into the toilets.
Into the ladies.
Right, where are they? In here.
they are, then.
Come out, or you'll feel the full force of my plasma gun.
Come from anyhow?
Well, according to the old historian, when the earthquake comes, all the evils of the world will be released, and here they are.
Right then, load your gun. Certainly not. They're living creatures just like ourselves. Admittedly, they live in a different time zone. A bit like Martin Butcher.
You mean we've got to respect them and return them unharmed to the underworld?
Correct. So let's clear the biology department of our unearthly friends.
Friends? If they come near me, I'll give them a shot of my ectoplasm gun. Rob, why hasn't Butch joined us?
I haven't seen it for a while. He's probably working night shifts.
I suggest we go and have a good look in all the cupboards for the ghosts.
Things.
Oh, yes.
get you, little swine. Let's take it to the plasmatron.
We've been given us force fields to check. It should be easy to spot any ghosts.
That's if we know what we're looking for.
You two, you don't seriously think there's any ghosts here, do you?
Hey, I didn't seriously think there'd be loads of bollards all over the school, but they appeared overnight.
It's a load of old bollards. There aren't such a thing as ghosts.
We could be looking for anything, from flying skeletons, ghouls, even ectoplasms.
What about someone dressed in an old sheet?
Mike, take this seriously. Ghosts like that only appear in films.
But isn't this a film?
I suggest we head for the pavilion. Come on, let's go.
Of the plasma gun.
I wouldn't do that, because look!
Same here. The laws of physics say they don't exist either.
So why are we armed to the teeth with plasma guns?
Just in case.
Just in case of what?
Just in case the laws of physics are wrong and we do find ghosts.
Look, Julia, it's just a precaution.
You're scared, admit it.
Well, I ain't afraid of no ghosts.
And I ain't afraid of no ghosts.
So if you're not afraid of no ghosts, let's go and look in the chemistry department.
Thank you.
What's up, Doc?
Wow, if there isn't one, there's more. Come on then, let's go get some more. Wow, look at that, it's 2Z. I teach them.
I baggy blasting Lewis Cavell.
I baggy taking Ryan Tip Lady.
I quite like Michael Knight.
Ready, steady,
fire!
That's it. All the teams have entered their ghosts into the plasma truck.
Do you think they've got them all?
My ectoplasm detector indicates that there are none in the immediate vicinity.
None in the immediate vicinity? What does that mean?
Well, hopefully, the school is clear.
Now what do we do?
We connect them to the portal and release them back into the underworld.
I'll connect it to the portal.
Turn the plasmatron into reverse. That's it. They're gone forever.
Who said they're gone forever?
What do you mean?
They're gone until the next time the Earth cracks and they escape to wreak havoc.
Okay, that's it. Job done. You've saved the school and the world from complete annihilation.
Go, Pockbusters!
You better come.